Hey guys, Dr. Prometheus here, back another episode of our Grand Tactician 1861 Union campaign. We are going to be pushing this fight. This will be a battle this episode. Probably all the episode will be us having a big battle against the Army of the Shenandoah. They should take it. I believe the Army of the Shenandoah is under... Not Albert Sidney Johnson. Probably Joseph E. Johnston. Come on, McClellan. You can do it. You can get in combat. So close. Hey, we got Enfields, all in the Department of Ohio. Field guns, Napoleons. If Okay, we'll see. Auxiliary rifles. Guys, come back. They should. Enlistment is over by the end of the month, I think. Okay. Battle of Clarksburg, Virginia, May 19th, 1861. 35,000 under the command of Major General McClellan, 37,000 under the command of Major General Johnston. This is going to be a good, good battle. McClellan and Joseph E. Johnston duking it out at what looks like the New Market battlefield here. Yes, it is. We're coming from the now north. They're going to be coming from across the river, so they're going to have New Market. We're going to have reinforcements, it looks like, from Helms Bottom. We're not going to have our full troops. We're going to have 23,000 to start the battle. So at this rate, we're going to be fighting over an area of New Market. The real question is, which part do I want to put up a defense? If I were to pick one, it would be... Manners Hill. I'm unsure if we can get to Manners Hill fast enough. We do have some cav. That I think can get there fast enough. I think. I'm unsure if we'll get here in time now. You got defenses here. They could cross here at the stone bridge. Ultimately, if they go up to Stones Creek, come around to our north, that's going to be an issue. Something I think the AI would do. That. Oh, it canceled his move. Yep. There at the crossing, it looks like. Does my reinforcements come? 6 hours? Gift. Here. Here. Hold on. I need to first back down below my flank. Aim's up here. About skirmishers. Thank you. They're in disarray right now. We got the first cav here firing. This is all first combat for many of these units. Actually, for all of these units. I think once we get our full line up. We'll come up and fully engage them. Then we'll pull all of our units back. Be able to do it. Their cav is taking a beating here. They're trying to form their battle line. So are we right now. Fisk. Fisk Duval. Fisk is. Do we recall him here? Okay. All skirmishers. Mount, cav, move back. March the men forward. That's the thing, we have Enfields. But we outmatch them right now. Many of you might ask why I'm moving up, because I don't want to exploit the AI right now. And our rifles are much, much better at close range. So we're gonna move in. Closer range. Plus, we have them in like a downhill type of advantage right now. And their left flank is crumbling. More coming from the back. See, we're melting them through since we're a lot closer now. Imagine fighting this close. Like that's insane. Their alliance in many ways are crumbling. To push them out of that position. Our calf can deal with this, I think. Yeah. Breck is getting chewed up right now, but his course. Rockin' Bro is really getting chewed up right now. More coming at our flank. Two hours until the additional. It's come. Okay, now Harrison's brigade is getting ate up. Okay, now it's all about Scott's brigade. Rosecrans has the our extreme left flank. We're moving the brigade the other side. He's not going to get there fast enough. Montgomery's not. We can get Harrison to retreat. Saunders got out of the cover. Starting to degrade his ability to stand and fight. More reinforcements coming. Our reinforcements won't be able to guard our northern flank. We're gonna have to fold down towards Bushong's farm. 14-15 right now. Got Saunders to retreat back from the line. So Scott's brigade is taking the brunt, Grossbeck and Fisk. Duvall switched targets to in the course. Leroy's there. Beck is being eaten up right now. Being course, and I think we have another one. And now movement. We have movement of brigades. Extreme left, we need to fall back because they're going to come up from behind us. We need to round our line. Okay, rounded and fire. Rosecrans. They are starting to fail. Their flank is. You can't hit him. What do you? Yes, you can. Okay, now they're gonna bring up more. I think we're about to be under a full sail assault at this point. If you aren't already. They're sending more and more at me. Okay, will you move over here? Robinson with these 10-pound parrots. Okay, push. Good major victory at Clarksburg. Casualties may not be good for a couple of brigades, but... all in all, pretty good for some. Breck took some hits. Some Fisk. We're gonna upgrade after combat. We got low ammo here. Let's pull back. Pull back. Mount. not being able to cross the river. We trapped him up against the river. There it is. Better Enfields getting up close. Cavalry did some work. On department, couldn't even get on the field. Okay. Injured, 1,400 wounded. Okay. Took 9,000. A lot of wounded casualties that they'll get back. 1,200 killed, 850 missing. I know we didn't have any wounded. We lost Colonel Young. He was wounded. Colonel Saunders. For us. I don't think we had anyone get injured. No, we didn't. Consolidated. See how it looks. 1st Division with the Indiana Brigade, West Virginia Brigade. These are our 3-month troops here. Did a lot of work. Took some casualties, though, for them. But did fairly well. In those. 2nd Brigade. Well, funded for the 4th Brigade here. It's pretty good. They got banged up, though. Took 500 casualties. 4th Brigade's under the command of... Colonel Breck. Yeah, that was the one there. Rosencrantz was doing an alright job. So... That was yeah, I think these numbers are messed up. But that was the Battle of Clarksburg. Crazy picture. They lost 2,000, they lost 9,000. Brigadier General Fry gets honors. Let's see where he is. I think he's in command of division. I think. Actually, I think he's in command of a brigade. Our artillery did some work there. On the hill behind us. The instant I saw them running up to get in position, I knew that was the point where I can push up and attack the battle line. Good. 3,800 rifles and 1 gun from the battlefield. Department of Ohio. Fry is the artillery division commander. Okay. Yeah, like I said, the artillery was doing some work, so pretty good here. Department of Ohio set this up now. I come down to Charleston, cut through Clarksburg. Mountain Department is going to move to Grafton. Not worried about this. Take the second corps. Let's leave the second corps. Get to all these place. Fuel's going down there. Or train. Iro. Iro, Illinois. Fleet. Those double unders are yours. Here. Okay. Like him, okay. Hold on. Roman and Northwest should be. You would have should. No point should they stand and fight that. Yep. Greeted. Ellen, Charleston, apartment. Here. Still gonna have to probably deal with the Army of the Shenandoah, the Mountain Department. So probably get ready. Probably. Or under no gun. Yoga, photon, only it. Yeah, let's see. Did it cyclone 24th? Oh, not yet. Let's see. Kind of want to see that before done with this episode. They're gonna expire maybe by the end of the month, maybe. Now Don Carlos Buell's down here in London. Good depot down here. Custer. Jocelyn rifle carbine. I don't know when these were raised. I'd like to go 3. Sorry, Slocum, you're not going to be out here. Welcome here. That's fun. Locum is probably a good choice. Just don't know where you got it. Probably if I had to guess. He had good stats. Reynolds. Down Sedwich. There's Sickles. Slocum in charge of the militia. Thomas there. I think the next commander we probably need to put in. Probably run. Serves. See how it kind of goes out. Price. Commanders are good. Grant's out in the his army. We might end up giving him his own core. Probably put Sickles in charge of that. Because we want hilarious. Okay, on the by the third. Plus the apartment. And nothing. When did the war technically start? Wasn't it around like the 6th? I see when this year. Not yet. Okay, it looks like in the next episode we will figure that out. So, one thing we're also going to do in the next episode, we are going to build telegraph stations. We got a couple out here. We have one here. We have a couple that are like in range. Kind of how they work is you have this one's in line with this one. This one is in line with this one here. This one is in line with this one, which allows contact from. I think what we're going to end up doing, getting a army together. Like by itself, it's gonna be making. Oh, let's do it right now. Ohio. Give it to Riley. Down here. Give them. We can eventually just move these. Do them with some Wisconsin boys. So we don't screw it up. Army Corps of Engineers. So they end up down here. As you see, there's not a line. So we have no actual cable here. So we need to come down to like here. We're going to build a line here. And essentially what we're going to do is we're going to build a line here. I'm going to, if it reaches, I'll build a line just north of Louisville. We'll build a telegraph line here. Hopefully it's within this circle or we'll find one. And then same thing as we'll build one here, build some out here, so we have easier communication to move our armies quicker, which would be a distinct advantage from the fact that the South only has one in this area for Richmond. They don't have anything out. I think that'll be one thing that I end up doing in a Confederate playthrough is actually getting our ability to issue orders at least south of Richmond adequately for our next southern campaign, and being able to get orders out at least in the front itself. That would be one big thing. It's not really a big issue when it's around Richmond. Thing is, when I'm doing the campaign like I'm doing out here, out in West Virginia, it becomes very beneficial for the Union to move around troops because the orders can get there faster. They could push areas faster. These orders are out here, it may take approximately 7 or 8 hours at least to get movement out. Thing is, with these are getting movement orders within an hour to 2 hours because they're connected to it, and I'm able to push areas a lot further. Like, camped here, and if that was an enemy that decided to attack me, there's no way I could avoid that battle. I would like that. So it forces you to have forces further away. Like, I would have been in Grafton and him in Wheeling. And then from there, if I had to retreat, that might get me ample time to get orders to the army in Grafton down to Beverly and back to the Shenandoah Valley. Retreat that way. Or have them retreat through Clarksburg and back down. That's one of the big things with telegraph stations, and that's why we're kind of dominating around Northern Virginia, is they're not able to really counter me as effectively as they probably want to. So they're marching the Army of the Potomac up at me through the Shenandoah Valley. We have the First Corps here. It's only 14,000. They would be reinforced by the 2nd and 3rd Corps, or at least the 2nd Corps. But at this point, actually, all the corps would be here. If we have this attack, I think we might end up attacking Richmond. I think it's about time. We have 170,000. Yeah, I think. So I liked it when they actually recruited a lot faster. We do have it on the highest difficulty, but seems like the fix they did allows the player to outnumber. But we'll have to see how this works, the Southern campaign. All right, guys, leave a like below, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next episode. Later.